It's 5:30. This is WKYT This Morning. Election day is tomorrow. What the presidential candidates have to say in some of their final pushes for votes in key states.
Also on WKYT This Morning, we're learning new details about the death of a Boy Scout in the Red River Gorge. Why rescue crews say his death was very hard for them.
And a central Kentucky community honors a fallen officer 1 year after his death. What they did to honor Officer Daniel Ellis and his family.
This is WKYT This Morning.
Kentucky mornings start right here on WKYT. Good morning to you. It's your Monday. I'm Bill Bryant.
And I'm Andrea Walker. It is November 7th, which means, of course, tomorrow is Election Day. Right. It's what everybody's really thinking about today. But in the meantime, today's weather is kind of chilly, isn't it?
It is a little bit chilly, and these mornings have been that way. Micah says the afternoons are going to sort of join in as we go through this week. We've been wondering where the cooler air is, and it's arriving.
It's arriving, absolutely, especially later on in the forecast. I mean, we actually have 2 days where our highs could be in the upper 40s to lower 50s. So get ready for that. That's some really cold air sliding on in. I'll show you when that happens in just a few minutes. Right now, we're in the actual 30s and 40s outside. And so it's a chilly start to the day. Once we get into the afternoon, it's one of those days you're going to have to throw on a light coat before you start off your day. And then afternoon, you can get rid of it. You'll want some shorts and a short sleeve shirt. We're roughly 70 degrees because there will be a 30 degree swing in our forecast from morning to afternoon. We're going to talk about your Election Day forecast and show you if we have any chance of rain. I'll have that coming up in a few minutes.
And we'll see in a bit. And in the news, we've learned some new information overnight about the death of a Louisville Boy Scout.
Search and rescue crews say 11-year-old Jack Rose died on a camping trip at the Red River Gorge. WKYT's Lauren Miner is at our live desk this morning. Lauren, what new details have we learned?
Well, Andrea, we have learned from WDRB this morning that 11-year-old Jack was part of Troop 30 in Louisville. Leaders with Boy Scouts of America have also released a statement saying, quote, "We will do all we can to support the family of this young man. We will be offering grief counseling to our members and volunteers," end quote. Jack was one of 20 scouts on the trip to the gorge. He was there on a camping trip near Chimney Top Creek with his troop when a dead tree fell and landed on his tent with him inside. A pair of doctors who were camping nearby, along with search and rescue, attempted CPR, but the tree hit Rose in the head, killing him instantly. Wolf County Search and Rescue volunteer John May says he's seen a lot of tragedy during his 13 years, but this has been the toughest.
This is the first juvenile that we've had to really deal with like this, and you know, it just, especially if you have children of your own, I mean, it's just heart-wrenching to really, you know, see the pain and suffering that a family member and the friends are going through.
May says it's not that uncommon for trees to fall in the area, and it's important to be mindful of your surroundings because you never know what condition one of those trees may be in. Reporting at the live desk, Lauren Miner, WKYT.
Lauren, thank you. Such a heartbreaking story.
Oh, it really is. Yeah, very difficult. And obviously for those first responders, exceptionally difficult, given that so many of them can relate to the situation.
Yeah. In other news, Election Day is, of course, tomorrow, and we've seen a heated campaign season in national races and, of course, here at home as well.
It all comes down to this. We're keeping a close eye on Kentucky's U.S. Senate race this morning. Democrat and Lexington Mayor Jim Gray is challenging the incumbent Republican Senator Rand Paul for the seat. WKYT's Mike Byer is live in Lexington looking ahead to all of their campaign stops today, and they're numerous.
Good morning, Bill. The two men in Kentucky's U.S. Senate race are making a combined 17 stops around the state as the polls open in about 24 hours. Now, Senator Rand Paul is kicking things off this morning at the Aviation Museum here in Lexington. Paul will also be making stops in Louisville and Elizabethtown along the way before ending the day in his hometown of Bowling Green. His challenger, Lexington Mayor Jim Gray, is getting some high-profile help in his quest to unseat the senator. We've learned from former Kentucky Governor Steve Beshear will be with Gray during his 9 stops today from Pikeville to Paducah. Kentucky's U.S. Senate candidates have struggled to excite voters as the two compete with the presidential race. Now, we will be live tomorrow morning with the polls open at 6 a.m., and we'll have special election coverage throughout the day, and we'll be here as the numbers come in. If you're planning to vote tomorrow but don't know where to cast your ballot, we have plenty of helpful information on WKYT.com. Live in Lexington, Mike Byer, WKYT.
Mike, thank you very much. U.S. Representative for Kentucky's 6th District, Andy Barr, will be campaigning across the Commonwealth today. Barr will start his tour this morning in Lexington at a rally with fellow Republican and U.S. Senator Rand Paul. Barr will then make stops in several other stops in Bourbon, Fleming, and Clark counties. Barr is running against Democrat Nancy Jo Kemper. We checked Kemper's website and couldn't find any campaign stops listed for her today.
Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump make their final case to voters in several key states just one day before Election Day.
As the candidates crisscrossed across the country yesterday, FBI Director James Comey sent another letter to Congress to update them on the investigation into Hillary Clinton's emails. Craig Boswell has the latest on campaign 2016.
Donald Trump capped a five-state campaign push in Virginia overnight, railing against the FBI's decision to exonerate Hillary Clinton over her email controversy.
This is a rigged system. Hillary Clinton is guilty. She knows it. The FBI knows it.
After reviewing thousands of newly discovered Clinton emails, FBI Director James Comey penned another letter to Congress Sunday, revealing investigators are standing by their July decision not to bring charges against the Democratic nominee.
We're glad that this matter is resolved.
Clinton did not mention the FBI development as she rallied support in Pennsylvania, Ohio, and New Hampshire with the help of LeBron James and James Taylor.
I really believe that America's best years are still ahead of us.
Clinton's email saga has haunted her throughout the entire campaign. Despite the FBI's final decision, the issue continues to be a source of debate on Capitol Hill. In a statement Sunday night, House Speaker Paul Ryan used the topic to encourage Americans to vote for Trump, saying Clinton simply believes she's above the law and always plays by her own rules. Senate Minority Leader Harry Reid once again accused Director Comey of breaking the law for penning his original letter to Congress, writing, "Director Comey created a political firestorm 11 days before a presidential election merely to confirm what we already knew, that Secretary Clinton's email practices were legal." Voters will get their final say tomorrow when they head to the polls on Election Day. Craig Boswell, CBS News, Washington.
Donald Trump campaigns in five states today, including the crucial state of Florida's and Pennsylvania. Hillary Clinton will also be in Pennsylvania. She will be joined there by President Obama and the First Lady and Bruce Springsteen.
Janet Reno, the first woman to serve as U.S. Attorney General and the epicenter of several political storms during Bill Clinton's administration, has died. Reno's goddaughter says she died early this morning from complications of Parkinson's disease. She was in office for 8 years, starting in 1993, and was one of the Clinton administration's more polarizing figures. Reno faced criticism early in her tenure for the deadly raid on the Branch Davidian compound at Waco, Texas. She unsuccessfully ran for Florida governor in 2002. Janet Reno was 78 years old. Well, football helped bring some people in the Central Kentucky community together to honor fallen Richmond police officer Daniel Ellis.
Yesterday marked the one-year anniversary since Officer Ellis died. He was shot while investigating a robbery. Fellow Richmond police officers and Richmond firefighters honored Ellis at their annual Turkey Bowl. Those in the game say Ellis made a difference in the community, and their support helps Ellis's family.
I knew that today was going to be really tough, but just like today last year, I wasn't ever alone.
It was a hard time for us last year too at this time, and you hate to see anything like that happen, and we're proud to come out and honor it.
Ellis's son, Luke, delivered the game ball to the players. He also scored a touchdown and helped the Richmond Police Department get the win 24-19.
And some businesses in Richmond helped honor Officer Ellis as well with a kind gesture. They wanted to remind all officers that they have not been forgotten. All day yesterday, employees at the Domino's Pizza in Richmond provided pizza for the department. The manager there says the community has done a great job of rallying around the officers and the Ellis family, but now she wanted to do something a little special. She says on a difficult day, she wanted to deliver happiness any way she could.
It's just all about togetherness. We come behind each other. We stand behind each other. You don't feel in Richmond that you're all alone in the community. You feel like you've got somebody that's got your back, especially the police department.
Domino's split up the delivery so that every shift at the police department got pizza throughout the day.
A traffic stop turns deadly in western Kentucky, and state police are still looking into exactly what happened. Troopers tell us Deputy Chris Rainier stopped Randy Clark Jr. of Bowling Green in Butler County. Police say Clark outstanding warrants. They say he got into a fight with the deputy, and the deputy shot him with a stun gun. Troopers say Clark then drove away and dragged the deputy with him. They say that's when Rainier shot and killed 43-year-old Clark. Rainier was taken to a hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. We do not know how the deputy is doing this morning. Madison County will get thousands of dollars to help fix roads in the county. The state's transportation cabinet says the county will get more than $3,000 in county road aid emergency funds. About $1,700 will be used for Kanatzer Lane to repair flood damaged areas, and another $1,500 will go towards fixing flood damage on Eddington Lane. An animal shelter in Leslie County is also getting some help.
Right. Their volunteers there are installing a new roof. Sisters Saving Shelters in Lexington raised more than $6,300 in 6 weeks for the Leslie County Animal Shelter. That money is going toward putting a roof over the shelter's dog kennels. Volunteers say they used to have to shovel snow from the kennels during the winter. Well, this year they won't have to. Crews are hoping to have that roof finished up by some point this week. So there you go.
Very
helping
nice.
Them out there.
Yeah.
The time this morning is 5:41, and let's check live drive traffic now early on your Monday and see what's going on. Here, first of all, is a look at the region, and our current traffic situation is good. We have no reports of any delays. I-75, I-64, the southern split there looks good. Across the Clays Ferry Bridge, you're looking good. And, of course, the Martha Lynn Collins Bluegrass Parkway also running well right now.
All right, let's get a look outside, courtesy of the Lexington and Fayette Urban County Government live drive camera. We're looking at Man-O-War right now and Richmond Road. Things moving smoothly this morning. Of course, those will pick up here shortly as we head into your Monday.
And it looks like it's starting to do so.
Yep.
Well, we have more news coming up for you Monday morning on WKYT. We're glad you're up and at it early with us today. More news in a moment.
Still ahead, one Oklahoma City Thunder fan makes the shot of a lifetime and wins a whole lot of money. You won't want to miss this story. It's coming up right after Micah's forecast.
30s and 40s outside early this morning, and then we head throughout the next several days. It gets very, very chilly, maybe the coldest air we have felt so far this fall season. We're going to get into that coming up next.
Now, your hour-by-hour forecast with meteorologist Micah Harris.
We have 30s, 40s, and 50s outside early this morning. It just kind of depends on where you live. 50 degrees right now in Moorhead out in Rowan County. That's the 801 corridor. Interchange there with I-64. Frankfort looks pretty good, roughly 40 degrees. We'll finish off in the upper 30s. That goes for the Lennon-Corbin area. Already 33 right now in Wayne County. It's going to be a pretty chilly start down south. 69 by the afternoon, though. All of us will be there in the 60s. Some of us may even top out 70, 71 degrees. So extremely nice day. Then we head off toward tomorrow. Do we have any chance of rain? Tomorrow we do have a chance of rain, if you're talking about just 24 hours of that day. But it's going to be later on in the evening off into the night. It should not affect us as we're heading out to vote. 47 there as the polls open at 6 a.m. And it looks pretty cool and also dry. It stays dry through your day, too. So anytime you go out to the polls to vote, I just don't see much of a chance of rain, if any at all. I would say if there is going to be a chance, if anything changes, it would be toward the 6 p.m. hour when polls close, and that's going to be for the far, far western zones. But as of right now, I'm saying we're going to stay dry as we go throughout that period. Now, getting off toward Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, that's a different story. So here's what happens is results are coming in on your TV right here on WKYT and on WKYT.com. You're going to be looking at some rain moving over your house, too. Here's midnight. There's some showers moving on in. That goes throughout the night and into tomorrow morning. Obviously, it's not extremely heavy rain. You're not going to get much out of this. This is another one that doesn't really help us all that much, but it doesn't hurt us. There's 7 a.m. Wednesday morning, and then it just kind of fades away. But watch this as we head throughout Wednesday. Much cooler air filters on in. Wednesday afternoon, you're talking highs. These are high temperatures. These are not your morning lows. 49 Danville, 50 degrees across the Bluegrass region. Low 50s down south. I mean, it doesn't matter where you look. It is going to be pretty cold there on Wednesday afternoon. Hey, don't forget, follow me on Twitter, Micah Harris WX. I always get awesome shots like this one right here. Linda Taupin. How cool is that shot? First sunrise after the time change near the Ohio River. Awesome, awesome shot. This one had several, several retweets and 61 favorites. So this was no doubt about it, the Twitter pick of the day. 7-day forecast. Extremely nice conditions today and tomorrow. Like I said, it's a night chance of rain. that we get there on Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, so it shouldn't really affect any of us unless you're one of those third shift people. You got to get out late at night, early in the morning hours. Off towards your Friday, Veterans Day looks pretty good. It's going to be overall a cool day and very cold there on Saturday. Is another front blast on through here right now. I'm leaning more toward not seeing any rain on the weekend, but that cooler air rushes on in. Maybe our first freeze of the fall season. So here it comes.
That picture was gorgeous. I'm still back on that. I hadn't seen it yet.
Yeah,
beautiful.
Yeah, really, really good shot.
The color's amazing. So almost red, white, and blue.
That's right.
Interesting.
5:48 is our time this morning.
And this next story is just wild. A fan's first time at an Oklahoma City Thunder game had an absolutely stellar ending.
The fan, Tony, was chosen to shoot a half-court shot at the Timberwolves and Thunder game in Oklahoma City. Check it out. Tony lines up. He heaves the basketball and... swish. Look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
He made the shot. It earned him $20,000. Tony says he stayed calm ahead of the spot, that shot there. He says he's going to use the money now to help pay off his college loans for his student loans.
Good for him. How cool is that? Nobody makes that shot. You know what I mean?
Well, he did.
Good for him. Good for Tony.
Well, coming up, we'll have a lot more for you on WKYT this morning.
A look at the stories making news at this hour.
Check traffic again, see how things are moving along, some health news and more. Hey, it sure is good to have you up and at it with us this morning here on WKYT. Good morning. Welcome back in. WKYT this morning, live from Lexington at 5:52. So good to have you along.
It is. Let's take a look now at some of the stories we're working on for you this morning.
Our news team busy right now. Search and rescue crews in Wolf County say an 11-year-old boy was killed when he was hit by a falling tree in the Red River Gorge. Crews say Jack Rose, who is from Louisville, was on a camping trip with Boy Scout Troop No. 30 on Saturday night. WDRB in Louisville reports Jack was alone in the tent at the time. The coroner says the tree hit him in the head, killing him.
Today, the two men in Kentucky's U.S. Senate race are making a combined 17 stops around the state. Senator Rand Paul is kicking things off this morning at the Aviation Museum in Lexington. His challenger, Lexington Mayor Jim Gray, will campaign with former Kentucky Governor Steve Beshear during his 9th stop today from Pikeville to Paducah. Topping your national headlines this morning, Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump make their final case to voters in key states one day before Election Day.
And as the candidates crisscrossed the country Sunday, FBI Director James Comey sent another letter to Congress revealing his agency did not find anything new to warrant charges against Clinton for her use of a private email server. Clinton did not mention the development at any of her events yesterday, but Trump criticized the decision, saying his rival was being protected by a rigged system.
In other news, a trendy habit your teenager picks up now could lead to a bad habit in the future. That tops your morning health headlines.
I want to keep it in mind. New research indicates middle school and high school students who use flavored e-cigarettes are more likely to become smokers. Doctors found 58% of young people using sweet-flavored e-cigarettes expressed intentions of picking up the cigarette habit.
Well, the 80s are back on television, and Beyonce lands on another list of luminaries.
Suzanne Marquez has those stories and more in your Eye on Entertainment.
Music megastar Beyonce made Ebony Magazine's Power 100 list. It honors outstanding achievements by black entertainers, athletes, leaders, and professionals. Other honorees include filmmaker Ava DuVernay and musician producers John Legend and Nas, who will each be featured on the cover of the upcoming issue. Actor-singer Leslie Odom Jr. also made Ebony's list. Fresh off his hit jazz album, the Tony Award winner is releasing a holiday song collection this Friday. Simply Christmas features jazz versions of classics like Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas and The First Noel. Workers at Red Oaks Country Club return to work in this 1980s throwback comedy set in New Jersey.
Look at you. Come here and give me a man hug, will you?
Come on, put some pelvis into it,
okay.
The show follows assistant tennis pro David Myers, his family and friends. Paul Reiser and Jennifer Grey co-star.
Everybody has gone through what these characters have gone through. At some point, you know, there are transitions and there's growing up and what am I going to do with my life? From the younger actors and then our characters as
empty
well.
Nest.
We're all going through changes.
And, yeah, it's like if you're not changing,
you're dying.
The season 2 of Red Oaks debuts this Friday on Amazon Prime Video. And that's your Eye on Entertainment. Suzanne Marquez, CBS News, Los Angeles.
All right, let's get a check this hour on today's traffic trouble spots with live drive traffic.
See what's going on out there. Here is a look at the region right now, and it looks good. We have no reports of any problems along the interstates or the parkways this morning. Everybody moving along, even traffic in Lexington at this moment is somewhat light on this Monday, but we anticipate that will be no doubt picking up very shortly. In fact, we'll take a look right now.
Courtesy of the Lexington Fayette Urban County Government, right now we are looking at Nicholasville Road and Alumni Drive. Everything moving smoothly this morning.
I would say it has that early look, doesn't
it? Does,
because
doesn't
it sure stacks up a little bit later on. Everybody keep that in mind as you get ready to go this morning. All right, it's chilly out there this morning. You'll certainly notice that. You have been noticing that in the mornings here lately, but
it'll warm up a little bit towards the afternoon.
A little bit.
Yeah. Let's head over to meteorologist Micah Harris for an early look at your weather.
Yeah, it's another day where it starts off really chilly and then finishes off really nice. So it's just one more day where it looks like it could be a 30-degree swing from morning to afternoon, starting off in the 30s, 40s, and even a 50-degree reading in Rowan County. It just kind of depends on where you are early this morning. By the afternoon, roughly 70 degrees, and then we head off towards your evening hours. I don't see any problems there out at the ball fields. So we're sitting there in the low 60s. It'll be rather cool, but you got to remember, it is November, right? Heading off into the night and into tomorrow morning, we start off in the 40s, but then we pick up things as we head throughout your day. Tomorrow, as things actually look really nice for Election Day, it's Election Day night into Wednesday morning that big changes come. We'll talk all about that coming up. Another hour of WQYT News. He wants